Hey kids, Miss Kulkarni here again. We are going to continue with our Unit 2, Chemistry Calculations. And let's begin with our next topic, which is scientific notation. Hey, in scientific notation, there are mainly two parts. And which are these two parts? Let's take an example. Maybe let's say it is 3.8 times 10 to the 5th. That's the number which I have. And then the first part which we have, 3.8, is called as a coefficient. And then the second part which we have, 10 to the 5th, is called as an exponent. Okay. Now there are some rules, restrictions about both coefficient and exponent. One of the important thing is a coefficient must be a number between 1 and 10. So which means I cannot have this written as 0.38 times some number. Or I cannot have this written as 38.0. No, I have to have the coefficient between 1 and 10. About the exponent, exponent could be either one. It's just telling you it can be negative or it can be a positive value. Both are the valid answers which we get there. Okay, now coming to the conversion from scientific notation to decimal form. I know you all have calculators and we are going to actually go over how to use the calculator. But sometimes it's simple to convert that by knowing this basic rule. If the exponent which we have is positive, like this one we have a positive exponent, then you move the decimal point to the right. We have the decimal point, we move it to the right. And if it is negative, we move it to the left. So those are the conditions. Let's take some examples. Maybe if we have say 1.2 times 10 and nothing means there is a 10 to the power 1. If 1 is the exponent, that means it's a positive one, you're going to move to right by one place. So your answer becomes 12 or 12.0. Whereas if it's negative, and let's take an example of 1.2 times 10 to negative 1. It's negative 1, so we go left with that decimal point. So that becomes 0.12 as our answer. So you can always use this simple notations to find out the correct answer to decimal point or vice versa. Now the calculations about scientific notations we are going to work in our class, next class which we have there. So this slide here shows how to use a scientific calculator. Those are the basic instructions, and as I said, we will use those in our next class and work practice some calculations. So let's move on to our next topic, which is significant figures, or which we call as sig figs. My common name for that is, my pet name for significant figures is sig figs. There are all these rules for how to find out sig fig for a number. And they all are good rules. But you know what? I'm going to tell you a secret. I am not going to use any one of those. I am going to use a simple trick method for finding out the sig figs. So what is this? This is a little geography, I guess. And what we have is a map of United States. On the west coast, this is west coast, we have pretty Pacific coast. And on east coast, we have Atlantic. Right now I am going to tell you a trick in which this one has P, this one has A. If decimal point is present, I am going to begin my journey. Yes, we are going to go on a journey from Pacific. And if decimal point is absent, I'm going to begin my journey from Atlantic. And my goal will be going from one coast to other coast. So decimal point present, I will go from this to this, And if it's absent, I'm going to go from Atlantic to Pacific. And then we're going to find out how many digits which we get. Okay, now before we move on to next slide, let's do one simple practice problem. Okay, let's say maybe we have a number which is 501.2. So you look up that decimal point is present. That's decimal point. If it's present, you're going to walk from Pacific to Atlantic. That means if this is United States map, suppose if this is United States map, you are going to walk from left to right. And the idea is you start counting with the first non-zero number. 5 is not a zero. So that becomes 1. I count this, I count that, I count that. That gives suffix for the number as 4. Let's take one more example. Let's say maybe we have 602 as the number. Oops, you cannot really see that. 602 is a number. There's no decimal point. It's absent. So now I am going to go from Atlantic to Pacific. And I need to start counting from my first non-zero number. 2 is not a zero, so I'll count that, I will count that, I will count that. That gives me 3 suffix for that. But look what happens. If I have 600 as a number, there is no decimal point. I go from Atlantic to Pacific. But when I start counting, I will not count as 0. I will not count as 0. The only number I am going to count is 6. So for this number, I will end up having 1 suffix. So it's that simple. It's not that difficult at all. Let's actually do some practice over here. So these are some practice questions from your notes. The first number is 100. Decimal point is absent. I'm going to just write down here, it's absent. So you're going to go from Atlantic to Pacific. You're going to go like this, from right to left. And you're going to count from the first non-zero number. This is 0. So that doesn't count. This is 0, doesn't count. But there is that 1, you're going to count that. So there's only 1 suffix which we have there. Okay, over here, decimal point is present. That's the decimal point. So if it's present, you're going to go from Pacific to Atlantic. And you're going to count from non-zero number. 1 is non-zero, and then you keep on counting. Remember, you don't stop. Once you start counting, you don't stop there. So I'm going to count each and every number. That gives me suffix as 5. Let's do 4500. It is no decimal point there. It's absent. So I'm going to go from Atlantic to Pacific. I'm not going to count this. I'm not going to count this 0. But I'm going to count 5 and 4. That makes it 2 suffix. So, you got the idea how easy is this. Now, you might think over here on the left, 100, 100 point and 100.0, they all are same numbers and they will have same suffix. No, that is not correct. 100, as you saw, we ended up getting 1 suffix there. 100 point, it is decimal point present there. So, we go from left to right and then we count from first non-zero number. So, we get all of those and we end up getting 3. A suffix. Again, decimal point is present, so we go from left to right and we end up getting 1, 2, 3 and 4. We count all of those, it's 4. So if you check the answers for all of these, you can figure out it's simple. Once when you figure out it's present or absent, you can say which way you're going to go. So if it's present, it's always from Pacific to Atlantic and your counting is only after first non-zero number. Okay. So we got all these taken care of. And remember again, you don't stop once we start counting like this one. We start counting from 4 and 5, but we still continue counting the last 2 zeros. So we end up having 4 suffix. Now last 2 questions which we have here, they are scientific notations. And it's very easy to remember how we get suffix for that. In scientific notation, we are only going to focus on the first coefficient part, nothing else. And imagine if that's the number, how many figs we have. So 4.0 will have 6 figs of, can you tell me? Yes, it will be 2. And over here, 4.00 decimal point present, so it will be 3 there. So look at that, how simple is all these calculations. So let's do some more calculations and we can go into more details about sig fix. So you already saw how easy it was to find sig fix for any given number. Now, if there is multiplication or division, how do you find out the correct sig fix for the final answer? There are two main rules. One of the rule, first rule which we have is, when you multiply, you will have two or more numbers in that multiplication. You are going to find out the sig fix for all numbers. And then you find out the smallest number of sig fix. And that is the sig fix you'll be using for your final answer. So the second rule which we have is, if there is a multiplication with exact numbers obtained from definition, if it says the exact number, then we do not consider that number as the smallest number. So for example, if you have the mass of this object is given to you as 8 of the objects. So we have two numbers there, 8 and 0.2553. 8 is the exact number of objects for which sig fig will be 1 and for this sig fig will be 4. But for your final answer, you will not use 1 as sig fig, but you will rather use 4 as the number of sig fig. So let's actually do some real problems. Okay, moving on. Over here, we have a couple of calculations. Let's first find out how many sig figs we are getting for each of that. Decimal point present. So we go from Pacific to Atlantic. Okay, you already know that now. So if you count sig figs for that, we are getting 6 sig figs for that and 4 sig figs for that. When you multiply, you're going to select the smallest number of sig figs, which is 4. Over here, we have decimal point present, so we go it from Pacific to Atlantic, and over here, we go from Atlantic to Pacific. Sig figs for this will be 1, 2, 3, and 4. And for this, we are not going to count as 0, we count 8, 3, and 3, so it ends up giving 3 as sig figs. Out of 3 and 4, 3 is the smaller number, so we round up to 3 sig figs. And then this is present, and then look at that, it's an exact number 32. We are not going to consider the sig figs for 32 if it says exact number. That means we are going to round up whatever sig figs we have for this number, which is, I believe it is 4. And when we come back over here, this is decimal point present. So we end up getting 3 and 4. And then we round up to the smallest one, which is 3. So here are the answers I'm getting. The answer which I got for this was 3.860 times 10 to the third. Or I can also put 3860. They are same answers. Now I want to tell you one secret. It's always a good idea to write down the answer in scientific notations. That sometimes works easy. But again, it's your choice. The answer for second one which I got was 7.40. Remember, the answer which I got was different, but I decided to round up my answer to 3 sig figs. And I have exactly 1, 2, and 3. 3 sig figs there. The next one answer we have is 2.109, and I got 10 to negative 4, and the last one was 7020, or I put in scientific notation 7.02, 10 to the third. So the simple thing, guys, is we are going to simply multiply or divide as we normally do and round up the number to the correct desired sig fix. So you all know now the main concept of scientific notation and how to get correct sig fix. The whole idea of getting scientific notation and sig fix is to tell how important job chemistry people do. Yes, chemists are supposed to do experiments, supposed to do more research, and not to spend time in writing big long numbers. So we just write those numbers in short form, like this scientific notation. And even if the coefficient is trailing like a big number, we make sure we use correct suffix so it will be a short number. So I hope you enjoy this video. And then let's talk more about this in the class. I will see you in next video. Bye.